Round your neck, sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre, why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France, and a dinner here is never second best.
Yeah. friends pull through. How do they live high? Can you wanna go? Oh. Oh.
I'm the king of the land. I'm the king of rap dance. If you give me a chance.
Then goes hopping around, wearing boots like Gaston.
I use antlers in all of my decorating.
Life's like a road that you travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand. Sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door. The blues won't haunt you anymore. With a brave heart, free and lover's soul, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate. So break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
I'm Rachel Casway.
And I'm Julia Petrasky.
As you might have noticed, tonight's theme is Disney. Every year, Mr. East takes on a charity to support, and this year we are choosing Make-A-Wish New Jersey.
for a great show. I'm sure glad I'm not a judge. Let's get this show started. Now presenting Mr. Tall Drink of Water.
And that's how I lost my braces inside a piano.
Huh. Interesting. Wait, Peter, isn't your Mr. East back too soon?
It's doing like April.
It is April.
Oh, I forgot.
You forgot? How could you forget a big thing like this?
I know, it's a big thing. But what am I supposed to do?
Could you just like solve a Rubik's Cube or something?
That's been done so many times before.
They're fine. How about, kid, you sing a song?
Do you remember my Stay Tuned audition freshman year?
Sadly, I do.
I got it. I do math for fun. Maybe I can do something with that.
Oh, Peter, we've talked about this. No one but you does math for fun.
You do math for fun? That's so lame.
Okay, I get it. But this isn't helping. What am I supposed to do?
I think the guy who won last year ate like a raw egg or something.
An idea.
God, I hate it when you have ideas.
Okay, I know they're bad sometimes.
Sometimes?
Just trust me. I got it. You know, it's crazy. Just 4 short years ago, I was this tiny 6'5" freshman, and it's just honestly super cool that I'm a senior now. You're respected more, you have more life experience, people look up to you. No, literally, people look up to you. But anyway, that's besides the point. I just feel like ever since quarantine started, I've been missing something, something important in my life, but I just can't put my finger on it. So that's why I've decided to come back to the place where it all started, to find what I'm missing.
Peter?
Is this not our high school? How was I supposed to know this wasn't East?
I don't know, maybe because you go to East?
Well, sometimes I get lost.
Wait. Why don't you go to West? Isn't it like a 7-minute walk from your house?
Oh, the marching band.
Peter, you don't do marching band.
I know.
What? Anyway, we have to find a way to get out of here.
I got it.
What do you got? Stop changing the subject.
I know how we can get to East.
Peter, what? What?
Almost got it.
Peter, this isn't your car.
Hey. Mr. Rosenberg was right. I would need this one day.
Peter, I am not getting in this car. This is, like, actually illegal.
It's an educational experience. Now get in! So, do you want the airbags on or off?
On, please? Peter? I know you're from Poland, but in America, we drive on the right side of the road!
Jeez. Weird. That wasn't on the state exam.
You got 100 on that though, didn't you?
Yeah, but they didn't ask a question about it.
How is that even possible? Turn signal, not windshield wipers!
Go in reverse, okay!
Oh God, don't let me die here, please!
While Peter and his cameraman attempt to make friends with the local police department, please enjoy this brief intermission. We hope you enjoyed that brief intermission.
I know a shortcut. I think this is it. It seems that...
How tall are you?
I'm 6'9". Now, could anyone please tell
me... Do you play basketball?
I did in 8th grade. Please, could someone just tell me if the auditorium...
Do you hit your head on doorways?
I have never hit my head on a doorway. Now, could one of you just please tell me if the auditorium's open?
Oh, yeah, it is. It's just stage left.
Thank you.
Stage left, Peter.
I know.
Stage left!
Stage left. Left.
Let's go.
Fine. Wait, I have one more thing to do. Mr. Rosenberg, I have the assignment.
Peter, this was due a month ago. Last year.
So no partial credit?
My God, man, get out.
Did you have your interview with Mr. Reese?
You know what? I think I did. And? Well, it was just one more big adventure.
Ready to start a new one?
You know.
There's 104 days of summer vacation, and school comes along just to end it. So the annual problem for our generation is finding a good way.
Now that we all had a good laugh, let's take it back to the stage. Break a leg, Mr. Rose.
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax, just pull up a chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feel, and I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. The sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love. Let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the place. Come on with the rain, I've a smile on my face. I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing, singing in the rain. your heart. I did things to your only lovers would do in the dark. It made you a god. Priests, popes, and preachers would tell me I did wrong, but hey, it made a nigga flip. What do I say to make me exist? Oh, stranger.
Your dance moves. Now let's kick it to Mr. Jackie Chad.
Hey, what's up? Whoa, fellas, is this just because I'm Asian?
What do you mean, dude? We are too.
Bro, I'm... We stand in support of AAPI. Oh, well, I can't really argue with...
Yeah, let's go.
Sleep is the brother of death.
What? Where am I? Where's my drip?
He who asks is a fool for 5 minutes. He who does not ask remains a fool forever.
Thanks for the elaboration.
What's
the Kodyu Kai? Isn't that led by the drip dragon? They're a bunch of kung fu killers. How am I supposed to get my stuff back?
If you want to find out about the road ahead, then ask about it from those coming back.
Bro, can you speak in anything other than Chinese proverbs?
100 no's are less agonizing than one insincere yet.
Hey, my house is in the other direction. Oh, what are we doing at East? Oh, you know, I heard they're gonna crown me something they call Mister.
It is time.
Yo! Karate revenge time? That's so hype, bro. Tell me, is there a manual for this funky business? Or are you just gonna show me what's up, you know?
It's better to be without a book than to believe a book entirely.
Okay. Let's do this.
Dirty window is a broken lens. Looking through it skews one's perspective.
Man, I'll do your chores, but please spare me the proverbs.
You are ready, young disciple. Reclaim the drip.
Yo, they're gonna get down.
There you are, punk. Thought you could get with this little plan of yours, huh?
Yeah, I was actually hoping to pay you and your boss a visit
really?
Sometime soon.
Are we doing
yeah.
this?
We'll be back for more.
Gotta wash to match that jacket, Dragon Boy.
Ding! Are we doing this again?
Yeah, let's go.
I am not doing this anymore. That is enough.
Wish to seek defeat?
Is it because of this?
I've come to reclaim what's mine, Drip Dragon.
My drip is eternal.
drip is not forever. Friendship is.
Are you okay? No.
You bested me in a fight. Tell me, who are you?
You can call me Mr. Jackie Chad.
Everybody was kung fu fighting.
Well done, Mr. Jackie Chad. I definitely wouldn't want to get on your bad side. Now let's take a trip over to Neverland. Here is Mr. Brick.
Dude, where is Neverland, man? Hey, get out the way, man. Get out the way, dude. Come on, where am I going? I can't find Neverland.
Where am I?
What is this place? Home of the cougars? Where are the cougars at? Where are the cougars at? Where is Neverland, man? Hold on. Wait, these guys might be able to help. Hey, you guys!
Who's that?
Hey!
No, I think he's coming closer.
Oh my god, help! Oh my god!
Take me to Neverland or else!
Hey, hold up, bro. We just struck a deal.
Yeah, bro.
Give us our friend back.
Tell me where Neverland is!
Fine, but only if you win Mr. East.
Fine! I'll do it!
Fuck!
You gotta drip you out first, bro.
Drip, bro!
What even is Mr. East?
Listen, bro, let's take a walk. Mr. East is a competition through which the greatest senior of this class is crowned as winner.
But how do I win?
Well, you're gonna need some upgrades first.
What do you mean?
The chain. The glasses. And, bro, we're gonna have to get rid of that hair.
My hair!
This is for Neverland and Mr. East.
Yeah!
Oh my god!
So we've got the drip down. Now it's time to secure the deal.
Let's go, mate. Do you want to hook it up prom with me?
Have you ever had the feeling you're drawn to someone?
Do you want to hook it up prom?
Could have said or done. And every day I see you on your own. And I can't believe it's you're alone. Is what they said. That you're looking for a boyfriend. I see that. Give me time, you know I'm gonna be there. Don't be scared to go, but you trust in me. Can't you see? All I really wanna be is your boy.
Woo! Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here, up in here.
That was pretty good so far.
Yeah, I think with all the upgrades you've done, you secured the dub.
Hey, thank you, man. I'm gonna miss you.
Of course, I'm gonna miss you too.
One last song?
One last song.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of that ship was a Billy of Tea. The winds blew hard, her bow dipped down. Blow me, bully boys, blow. Soon may the weathermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go. Ran up in 2 weeks from shore, went down on her a right whale bore. The captain took all hands and swore, the winds are bad and low. Soon may the weathermen come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go. Hey boys, it was nice knowing you. I appreciate it. I'm gonna go back to Never Never. Goodbye!
Yeah! Neverland was more than I could have imagined. Up next, let's see how strong Mr. B. Hayden's act really is.
Tonight on 60 Minutes, we profile and interview child prodigy Mason Blicky, who vanished over a decade ago and has resurfaced. Here is his story. Mason Blicky, visionary, genius, American patriot. At age 4, he was chosen to be the next Captain America. At 8, he was on his way to be an Olympian. By 9, he graduated from MIT. When we last saw him, he was working with some of the biggest names in sports and business, but tragedy struck. He simply disappeared.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure being here.
It's been about 10 years. The road is curious. Where have you been?
So at the age of 11, based off stress, my parents decided to move me off the grid. So this is my return to relevance. I've been gone for a while, and I'm ready to return, so I'm back.
Younger audience who might not know you, can you tell us a few things about yourself and what you accomplished?
I would like to say that I was definitely born special. I think I was born with definitely a gift that nobody else in this world possesses. Anything I do, I feel like I do it the best. And I've taught many professionals over the years with their lives, their physical sport, or their mental life. So I've taught professionals of all ages, and I definitely would say I have a gift that no one else in this world possesses.
Can you give us some examples of your clients?
At just the early age of 10, I had a handful of clients. That consisted of teaching Shaquille O'Neal how to shoot free throws.
This is a love fest that has broken out here at Staples. Oh, playing.
Helping out Iverson with his finances. Teaching Charles Barkley how to golf. And most importantly, telling Magic Johnson which woman to date and which woman to stay away from.
People have said that you have lost your mojo and went into hiding. Is there any truth about that?
That's simply not true. Just last week, I completed a series of videos proving that I haven't lost a step.
I'm Mason Blicky, and this is my 40-yard dash.
Go!
.412. The top prospect of the 2021 NFL Draft.
Today, guys, I'm going to be bringing positivity into motion by bench pressing twice as much as I've ever done before. My dad told me with my eyes closed that you can accomplish anything if you really focus and put your mind to it. So here goes nothing.
Remember, Mace, close your eyes, and if you focus, you could do anything. 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, keep going, you got it. Yeah, you did it, 450 pounds.
400 pounds and 18. Arnold was only doing 318. You guys see that? Come on, let's go.
Today I'm going to be proving my point that with focus you can accomplish anything. Today I'll be attempting 5 free throws blindfolded.
Go.
Here goes nothing.
Yes! One down! Alright, Mace. 2! Whoa! Amazing!
Today I'll be demonstrating my math excellence.
All right, here we go. 98 times 65 equals?
2,700.
That's right. Right on. You got it. You're the man. 75 times 97 equals?
75 times 97 is 6,296.
Got it again. Nailed it.
What's your point of view of the world right now?
I haven't seen a TV or a newspaper since I was 11.
What if I told you right now that some of the things you're most famous for didn't turn out?
Stop the interview.
Mom.
As you can see, the interview was stopped abruptly. We had our experts review his videos, and this is what we uncovered.
Go.
What was that?
412.
412. The top prospect of the 2021 NFL.
Are you sure it's a 412?
Yeah, 412. I'm looking right at it.
It's a new record.
Remember, Mace, close your eyes, and if you focus, you could do anything. 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, keep going, you got it. Yeah, you did it, 450 pounds.
400 pounds and 18. Arnold was only doing 318. You guys see that? Come on, let's go.
Wait, did you get that on video? I need to send it to my friends. I need to show everybody. I just benched 450 pounds.
I got it.
Send me that when you can.
I'll send it to you. You guys edit it? You guys are going to have to edit this video.
Why?
To take yourselves out. Mace wants a video. Whoa! Amazing! 3! Woohoo! You did it! Oh, 4! That was so good! Way to go! Last one! Is it in? 5!
Swish, baby. That's how you do it.
That's right. Right on. You got it. You're the man. 75 times 97 equals?
75 times 97 is 6,296.
Got it again. Nailed it. Great job. 45 times 53 equals?
45 times 53 is 8,929.
Woo! That's it. Perfect. Last one. 82 times 67 equals?
18,424.
Yes! You did it!
Four
amazing,
four. Mason. I'm ready for my test.
Is there anything else you would like the world to know about your return to the top?
I'm just simply the best.
Hercules showed us some major strength. Let's see if Gaston can compete. Now presenting Mr. Study.
Have you guys seen Peter out recently? I can't find him anywhere.
Nope. Nah, I haven't.
He's been acting kind of weird ever since he got picked for Mr. East.
What do you mean, weird?
I heard he thinks he's that character Gaston from a Disney movie.
Beauty and the Beast?
He's been a total jerk and acting like he's better than everybody else for no reason.
Alright, let's just go with that one.
Yo, here we go.
Seriously? That's funny. Guys, I can't believe you've almost graduated.
Seriously, these past 4 years have flown by so fast.
And it's amazing that we've actually stayed friends through it all.
Except for Pete. I'm so tired of how he's been acting recently. I just wish we could go
no
back.
No one's slick like Gaston. No one's
not
quick like
head.
Gaston.
Kyle,
no one's neck is incredibly thick like Gaston for...
Oh, I didn't even see you guys there. I was too busy admiring my greatness.
Bro, shut up.
You need to be humble.
Hey. Guys, we're all friends here. Just because I was blessed with a chiseled jawline and bulging biceps doesn't mean you need to be jealous.
Ew. Man, this Mr. East thing has really changed you. What happened to ugly Pete?
Oh, Cosmo.
I've changed for the better.
I'm Mr. Study! Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a puny kid, I often noticed funny things that I did. Like joining theater at SGA. I'd sing a little at the end of the day. I see my friends and think I'm better than them. That's when I finally said
what
I said, please, I think so, please. You'll find a way to make a natural change. You will be Mr. East.
I'll be Mr. East.
You have the talent to knock out the rest.
Yes.
You will be Mr. East.
I'll be Mr. East.
People will scream out that you are the best.
You're the best.
I might be a little bit cocky, but damn it, I deserve to be the people's Mr. East. Mr. Sunny!
Oh, me! Oh my god! You can't take any more of this!
If you're out of control, man, get some help!
You know what? I don't need anyone. I am the greatest. Nobody can tell me otherwise.
I hope this new change is worth losing your friends.
Oh, I don't need any of them anyway. They just don't understand what it's like to be such a prominent person like me. I'm the people's mysteries, for goodness sake. I'm any of them.
How loud is the man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not.
This whole act out, man. This isn't you.
What do you mean? This is the best I've ever been.
Pete, literally no one wants to become your friends. Do you even realize how much of a repellent you've become?
Dan, that's just not true. Just look at me. Everybody wants me.
Pete, take a look around. You've lost your friends.
Dan.
I'm just still trying to help you. Hope you can change.
Maybe he's right. I've gotten so caught up in this Mr. East thing that I've forgotten who I am. I've forgotten how much my friends really mean to me. Hey guys, I'm really sorry for up and after recently.
Throw this on, big guy. As long as you're back to normal, Gaston.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, we all just wanted the old Pete back.
Thanks.
Glad you made the right decision, buddy.
You know what? We're all in this together, man.
Together, once we know that we are, we're all stars, and we see that we're all in this together. And it shows when we stand hand in hand, make our dreams come. We're all in this together. When we reach, we can fly, knowing sight, we can make it. We're all in this together. Once we see there's a chance that we have, and we take it.
Cougars everywhere, wave your hands up in the air. That's the way we do it, let's get to it. Come on, everyone.
Sometimes I think we could all learn a lesson or two from Gaston. Up next, we're gonna go to Mr. Pie Guy, who's gonna show us some real genie magic.
Oh my god, it's a cube. What is it?
Well, it's sort of like a Rubik's Cube, but it's not like one I've ever seen before. It's kind of weird. It's glowing.
Oh my god, why is it glowing? That's
the great genie of the Rubik's Cube. Oh my god, do you solve wishes or something? Do we get through them?
Well, yeah, what other genie do you know? Of course you get through wishes. Fire away.
Sorry, I wasn't having for a sarcastic genie, man. Hey, you got what you wanted, man. Bro, I kind of like cars too, man.
Yo, I wish for Lambo.
I hate to bother you guys, but you guys have to make wishes about Rubik's Cube. Sorry about that.
Oh, you suck, bro.
Hey, movies exaggerate genies, okay? It's not our fault.
Bro, Rubik's Cubes, man? Bro, I saw that when I was three, bro. Why did I ask for
it's better than nothing, right? I just made your day a whole lot better.
Imagine making a whole show just about Rubik's Cube. Like,
bro.
Who does that? That's so boring.
Okay, fine. Let's see what he's got, at least.
Okay.
Solve this.
Genie does as you wish. Voila. What's your second wish?
You know, that was kind of impressive, but you know, I heard this dude named Anish. He got one in 7 seconds. That's kind of
seconds. That guy could even do it while reciting the numbers of pi.
Yeah,
can you do it one-handed though? Because that'd be funny.
Yeah, I'd be impressed. Yeah.
Genie does as you wish. Just scramble to keep forming. Voila. What is your third and final wish? Remember, it's your last wish, so wish carefully.
That's not bad. Yeah, but I knew this other guy named Anish that could do it while reciting the periodic table.
Bro, I saw that at Coffee House, right?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I mean, I don't like Lambo still, but I mean,
yeah,
you can do it blindfolded. That would be not bad.
You guys don't have growth mindset, huh?
After Mr. Killian's class, you know, that kind of went away.
Of course.
But yeah, as he said, you know, blindfold would be pretty cool, and I really don't think you can do it, man, but good luck, you know.
Genie does as you wish. And final wish.
Man, this kid was kind of disappointing.
Good job, but it's kind of boring.
Thank you, but since you guys already wished for three things, I'm going to leave now. But just before I go, I was actually messing with you. You guys could have wished for anything you wanted, and you guys chose to wish for Rubik's Cube. I just wanted to, you know, flex my Rubik's Cubing skills over the past 1,000 years that I practiced, so thank you for letting me show them.
Did I not ask for a Lambo, man?
Bro,
I think he's capping right. He has to crap.
Wow, great job, Mr. Pie Guy. That genie really played some mind games. Now, let's go over to our last contestant, Mr. Getting It Done, to see what Aladdin has up his sleeve.
Wow. Aladdin 2 was really a cinematic masterpiece.
What are you talking about? That movie was completely unrealistic. Who breaks out into song and dance randomly?
Hey, man. Who says real life can't be like a musical?
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Besides, Jordan, you can't even sing.
I wish my life could be like a musical.
Jordan, that's not a shooting star, that's a rock!
Oh, 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 woke up today. Calculus test is in 4 minutes. Oh, 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 kick off my shoes and I brush my teeth. Time for Google Meet. The servers are down all over the town. It's like a message from high above. Oh, 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 now they're back up and I'm late, but like, who gives a f***? Good morning, Cherry Hill. Every day's a fantastic thrill. All my classmates are here with me, listening behind those black screens. Good morning, Cherry Hill. And if we were in person this year, you'd all make it out with a D. Cherry Hill East. Oh, 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 walking to school, completely forgot to wear pants today. Oh, 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 I've got my backpack, it's empty though. I'm ready to go. Cross country runs by, I see their whole thigh. They tell me, Jordan, you gotta move. Oh, oh, I walk through the door, kiss mezuzah, cause I'm a good Jew. Good morning, Cherry Hill. How is their construction still? Bathroom locked, and I gotta pee. Oh, this one smells like strawberry. Good morning, Cherry Hill. Don't get me wrong, I do love this school. And though it may not be the best, at least we're not West. I've met you before, I know who you are, but I cannot tell when you have that mask on. I see a kid cough and she scratches her nose. No, 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 get away from me, bro. So, oh, I got my vaccine, posted it on my Snapchat story. Oh, 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 now I can go to all the parties, so please invite me. Gotta graduate, like my parents did. Senioritis hit harder than COVID. Oh, 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 studying hurts. Can the teacher stop assigning work? I love you, Cherry Hill. Every day's a fantastic thrill. Megaphone in the library. Just checkmated Dr. Perry. And I promise, Cherry Hill, that I'm going to stand here until I get removed by security. Park my car here for free at Cherry Hill East. Let me be Mr. East at Cherry Hill East.
Yo, man, you good down there? Yo, get up. You alright?
Oh, I just had this crazy dream that I was in a musical or something.
Nah, man. You just got domed by a rock. You probably got some internal bleeding, maybe a concussion, maybe you broke your neck.
Maybe. Well, let's get out of here.
Yay!
Where are we going?
I thought you were driving this.
Well...
Wow, those vocal lessons really came in handy. And that concludes the talent portion. Up next, we're going to get to know our contestants a little bit better.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Cepeda. I'm a 2021 Mr. Each Chairperson. I'm here with Peter Slattery. What is your pageant name?
My pageant name is Mr. Tall Drink of Water.
And if you had three adjectives to describe yourself or your act, what would they be?
I would describe myself as tall, spontaneous, and iconic.
Thank you so much. Good luck.
Thank you.
My name is Rachel Casway. I'm a 2021 Mr. East Chairperson, and today I'm here with Tyler Burke. What's your contestant name?
Name is Mr. Brick, but everyone knows that already. You know.
Yeah. So, how have you prepared differently than your competition, and how do you think that gives you an advantage?
Wait, like prepare? You mean like practice? Like, so I can win? I don't need to. Like, I can do anything, you know? Like, I don't need to prepare. Like, I can backflip right now. You want to see me try?
Let's see it. I've never even tried
to backflip, but I guarantee you I can land it right now. You want to see it?
Mm-hmm.
Hi, I'm Aubrey DeMerge, and I'm one of the 2021 Mysteries Chair People. I'm here with Seth Hornstein, and what is your pageant name, Mr.?
My name is Mr. Rose.
And what sets you apart from other Mysteries contestants?
I think I'm different from other contestants because I really truly care about my act and what I'm putting forth. Like, we always say in theater that the freshmen are scared because they care. Well, when I was filming my act, I was terrified because I really, truly, genuinely care about how people perceive my work and I want to put my best foot forward.
That's great. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Julia Petrowski and I'm one of your 2021 Mr. East Chair People. And I'm here at the gym with Mason Balicki. What's your pageant name?
My pageant name is Mr. Be Hated.
So you own a business called Be Hated Fitness. How do you think that has prepared you for your role competing for the Mr. East title?
That has prepared me because whenever I see a camera, I'm the first person in front of it, and I'm not shy when it comes to taking off my shirt or removing my clothing. So I think that gives me the confidence, and it has definitely prepared me to become Mr. East.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Caitlin Cepeda. I'm a 2021 Mr. East chairperson, and I'm here with Tyler Seaman. What is your pageant name?
My name is Mr. Jackie Chad.
And what has been your favorite experience during Mr. East so far?
So far, I definitely say my favorite part of Mr. East is the opportunity I've had to spend time with a lot of people that I haven't been able to see because of Rona. There are some friends that, you know, you always see at school, but once school goes away, it's hard to connect with them and spend that time together. I really enjoyed seeing them these past couple weeks in preparation for my act, and I wouldn't trade these experiences for the world.
Thank you so much. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Hi again, Rachel Casway, one of your 2021 Mr. East Chair People. This time I'm here with Jordan Grossman. What's your contestant name?
Mr. Getting It Done.
So in the movie, Aladdin is granted three wishes from the genie. If you had three wishes, what would you wish for?
All right, one, wish for that magic carpet, take me and my boys out on a ride. Two, Chips Ahoy cookies with Oreo cream on the inside. They were here in 2015 and they discontinued them, but they were really good, trust me. And three, I wish I knew how to whistle.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Julia Petrowski. I'm one of your 2021 Mr. East Chair People, and I'm here again with Anish. What's your pageant name?
Hey everyone, my name is Mr. Pod Guy.
Okay, and your character is the genie, and he is known for being able to shapeshift into different characters of people. If you could shapeshift, what would you become?
If I could shapeshift, I would turn into a phoenix, just because I could fly and see the world in a bird's eye view. And I'd also be immortal, so nothing can kill me.
Neat. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Aubrey DeMerge, and one of the 2021 Mysteries Chair People. I'm here with Pete Cudahy. What is your pageant name?
My name is Mr. Studahy.
So, in the movie Beauty and the Beast, your character Gaston tries to swoon over Belle by singing her a song and showering her with gifts. What would you do to win the affection of a love interest?
So I would take a little bit of a different approach. I think that Gaston acts a little bit aggressively towards Belle, trying to like force her to fall in love with him. Instead, I would try to become friends with the girl first, see where things go from there, and then hopefully it falls in my favor.
Perfect, thank you.
Thank you.
Now that we've met the contestants, let's get to know our three alumni judges.
Our first alumni judge is Zach Abbo. Mr. Abbo graduated from East in 2000. His favorite teacher was Herr Mulman. During his time at East, he was involved in theater, SGA, and Battle of the Bands. He went on to receive his bachelor's degree in public relations at California State University, Fullerton. Today, he lives in Los Angeles, California, and is a music and entertainment manager.
Our next alumni judge is a 1998 East graduate, Joseph Zazamia. Mr. Zazamia's favorite class in high school was music and jazz band. He played football and was involved in orchestra and jazz band. He was also crowned Mr. East, class of 98. After high school, he went to Rutgers University, New Brunswick, for biology and continued on to Thomas Jefferson University for his master's degree in clinical pharmacology.
Our third alumni judge tonight is Patrick Kelly from the class of 1996. Mr. Kelly's favorite teacher was Mrs. Wilson, and he spent a lot of his high school career in D-Wing. He was part of theater, East Singers, and Madrigals. He graduated from Rutgers College in 2000 and is currently living in Chicago and working as an account supervisor for a small marketing firm.
Now, we would like to take a brief moment to thank our sponsors for helping us put on tonight's show.
With summer right around the corner, if you ever see your Mr. East on the beach, here's what you can expect. Up next, swimwear.
Mr. Brick likes to bump some classic rock and flex to show off his natty gains. He likes to lounge in the chair and bask in the sun. But sometimes that doesn't go too well.
Are y'all ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Oh!
After a long day of slacking off in school, Mr. Pie Guy goes to the beach, where he gets the chance to play some volleyball.
If nautical nonsense be something you wish,
Square,
then drop on the deck and flop like a fish!
Mr. Jackie Chad enjoys a peaceful game of catch. Well, maybe more like throw and miss while on the beach with his friends. Unfortunately, it looks like his spatial awareness is only rivaled by his catching skills. Mr. Jackie Chad's good mood sure turned crabby in a pinch.
Like most guys, Mr. Tall Drink of Water would love to imagine himself having rock-hard abs, but he's decided to work smarter, not harder. Instead of using the normal, everyday gym membership, he's using eBay. Just look at that bod. Tall, dark, and polished. Amazing instant results.
Mr. Getting It On spends his summer days down at the Jersey Shore. When you look this good, it's hard to keep the ladies off of you. But don't worry, he wears protection. From the sun, of course.
Mr. Studhe spends his average summer day working as a lifeguard. Here's him heroically saving a victim. It looks like he was too late. Mr. Behated loves going to the beach. While at the beach, he loves modeling his chiseled core and getting the ladies. Thank God there's 7 days in a week. Everyone wants a piece of Mr. Behated.
When Mr. Rose is at the beach, he likes to stay in the car because sand is gross. Mr. Rose's hobbies include losing his car in the parking lot, and buying too much, or in this case, too little clothing. Don't let his Squidward-like looks fool you. He's secretly a huge nerd that reads his chemistry textbook for fun. Also, make sure to never ask him about his trip to France. He never stops talking about it.
Wow, now I'm really glad I'm not one of the judges. Stay tuned as we process the results.
Need a last-minute gift for Mom? Something to spruce up that drab old office? Or how about a dozen roses for that special someone? Then come on down to Mushnick Skid Row Florist. We specialize in all types of flora. That's plant life, for those who don't know.
And while you're here, don't forget to visit our world-famous Audrey 2. It's named after me. No one's ever seen anything like it before.
Whoa, big plant! You ever see anything like that?
I don't believe I have. See? Told ya. And I'll bet you've never seen Cherry Hill East's Little Shop of Horrors streaming right into your living room either.
You mean Cherry Hill East did a whole show this year?
That's right, and you can stream it at showtixforyou.com.
How are they going to know when to stream if you don't tell them the date, Seymour?
Sorry. You can stream the full production April 30th, May 1st, 2nd, 7th, 8th, and 9th. Just search Cherry Hill East.
But we want to watch it together!
Well, then you should come out to Cherry Hill East on April 30th and May 7th at 7:30 p.m. for outdoor screenings. Tickets are only $15, and there will be live music.
Whoa! I'm gonna tell everybody about this. Hey, everybody! You can watch Cherry Hill East Little Shop of Horrors April 30th, May 1st, May 2nd, May 7th, 8th, and 9th on showtixforyou.com.
And we've got outdoor screenings of the show on April 30th and May 7th at 7:30 with live music.
I want to go.
Let's go get tickets.
Thanks to this weirdo plant, business is booming. So what are you still doing on the couch? Go buy tickets already.
And come see the world-famous Audrey 2, right here at Mushnick Skid Row Florist.
Don't forget the address of the shop.
Oh, shoot, the address.
Hurry, we only paid for 1 minute of advertising time.
Make sure and come and see it.